वंदे गुरुपद्दंडम भक्तबिंदुसमन्वितं श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितं श्रीनंदनंदनं वंदे राधिका चरणद्वयं गोपीजन समयुक्तं बिंदावनम वांशाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यश्च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचां कंगयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं वृन्दावितोषिते वै प्रिया वै केशवस्य च कृष्णभक्ति पदे देवी सत्वत्वै नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरये संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगद्वरम धैयम सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदोहम तेथास्पदं शिव विरंजनतम शरण्यं वेत्तातिहं पुनदुपाल भवद्विभूतम वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविंदम यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमणिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधूषुदर्श पूर्णानुरागरससागरसारमूर्ति साराधिकामयि कदा कृपां करिष्यसि श्रीकृष्णचैतन्य प्रभुनित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौर भक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे अजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावतातु संकीर्तनैकवितरो कमलाधिकाशु विशाम्बरु विजवरु युगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणावतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भवानुरूपेण सदा नराणां गङ्गातरङ्गरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनङ्गमदापहारम् वरानुसिपुरवती भजवीशनाथं वागीशजुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ते संविवं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। एवं गुरु पशुनैक भक्त्या विद्या कुटरेण सितेन धीरो विवृश्च जीवा स्वयमयम अप्रमत्तो संवृश्च आत्मनम अथो तैज्यस
गौरी गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद परमहंस जगत गुरु टोल्ड दैट सम डिवोटी क्वेश्चन्ड प्रभुपाद दी प्रभुपाद दैट व्हाई एक्चुअली इज दिस हैपेंड that so much in-depth vichar, that topmost absolute truth, that paramartha katha, most of the people, they are not at all accepting that. Why this is actually happening? That transcendental absolute supreme truth, that paramartha, that why most of the people not at all accepting that? What is the reason behind that, when they are not at all accepting that? That Deep Prabhupada speaking in context to this, that with so much topmost luck, very very rare person can accept that. And if your luck is very ill, that how you can accept that, you tell me. It is not at all possible. That sanskar should be there. That very nice sanskar should be there. That those people, those who are topmost luck, that their luck is very good. It means that previous sanskar is very good. They can with full surrendered mood, that all the time they can serve pure Guru Vaishnav. This all transcendental world, all absolute truth, about that supreme absolute truth, in order to understand them, they can accept that. That's why all these people, that by Bhagavat Kripa, by the Kripa of pure Guru Vaishnava, means that pure Guru Vaishnava Kripa means Bhagavat Kripa, that by Bhagavat Kripa they can understand that. Otherwise other people can't understand that at all. They are actually thinking they are so much intelligent, very very intelligent they are. Those who are getting hasty conclusions in their life, very immediately, are this is not at all this. Very hasty conclusions they are coming on to. Those who are actually taking that very easily, they're very immediately, they are taking without any discussion, without thinking, they are taking, and they are just putting one kind of logical arguments, whatever they can speak, they are speaking on their own. That these people are definitely, they are not at all eligible to accept that absolute truth, because they are thinking themselves as very super intelligent. That that topmost gyan, that divine knowledge, in order to get that, that in order to get that complete transcendental knowledge, whatever kind of knowledge we are getting in this material world, it is all actually governed by Maya Devi. In this material world, whatever kind of knowledge is there, its utility in this material world is actually confined in this world only. That kind of material knowledge about this Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur has told. It will just make all the jivas as an ass. This kind of material vidya, material knowledge of Maya Devi. So that complete knowledge, in order to get that, these people, just to that topmost knowledge, complete knowledge, which is the actual adhara of this whole material infinity world, that the actual mool object of this material world, which is the actual pran of this material world, which is Jagannath Bhagwan himself, that kind of topmost complete knowledge, that for that anushilan, that they don't have any time to just take that. That is the actual conception of Maya, actual trap of Maya which they are put into. We don't have any time in order to just hear about Bhagwan. That is actually called Maya, because we don't find time to hear Harikatha. Everything we have time to sleep, eat, drink, all rubbish things we want to do in our life, every time we are actually accommodating, but to hear Harikatha we can't accommodate time for that. For every thing we have time, but for bhakti we don't have time. Whatever you want to do, everything we have time for that, but to do Bhagavad Jivan and just to do kirtan, that is actually called Maya. That the topmost gyan, in order to get that divya gyan, you don't have even fraction of second at all. They don't have this kind of time that they can devote it towards Bhagwan. Deep Prabhupada speaking, that we from our childhood, we are actually getting getting grown up in the childhood, that materialism is so much in this kind of modern civilization, that about that transcendental world and that topmost divine knowledge, we don't have even fraction of second to discuss that, and we are not at all able to give even fraction of second for that. All kind of material behaviorism or mannerism, that 24/7 we are actually busy in that, and we don't have any time that we can devote it for our nitya seva at all. And all the time automatically jivatma, by that ahankar, he is actually getting entangled in the prison of that material body made of five elements. And what is that object actually? That who am I actually? What is me? What is my actual identity? That jivatma, nobody is actually making any kind of efforts at all to understand that who am I. They don't have time to understand that who am I actually, that what is that atma, what is the swaroop of the my atma. That kind of effort and that realization is not at all there inside anyone. But in this human life, 24/7, that paramarthic or spiritual realization about that, it should be all the time there inside our heart. And this whole material world is speaking that time is money, that which is just like beasts and birds, they are just moving. These human beings are thinking that time is money. All the gentlemen in this material world, they are thinking that 24/7 you just have to understand, just need to get about the material. They are actually have to just devote their time into spiritual practice. But what they have done, they are doing opposite. Their vichar is that time is money. But Prabhupada ji actually speaking that this is totally wrong. This is totally opposite Siddhant, that time is not money, time is paramartha. That even fraction of second also, if you will waste your time without Hari Bhajan, and within that period, Maya will definitely gonna attack you. And if we have to leave our body, then everything will go in vain. Because this shlok, we already know that. Automatically, that topmost transcendental object, and we don't have any kind of relationship with the material world. If we will speak like that, they are just getting angry on us. So what to do in that? That inside Maya, they are so much getting comfortable in Maya that they are not at all ready to accept the transcendental truth at all. In Maya, they are so much getting absorbed. That topmost object, they what is that transcendental object, they don't want to understand that, they don't want to put any kind of effort. But the Prabhupada speaking that 24/7, that in transcendental vishay, you just need to make sure that you are getting engaged in that, from where I have come, and this is just a 2 days life, what is the actual goal, after that what is the goal of my life, that should be known to us. Who will actually protect me from this? Definitely one master is there of this material world, that all this cause and effect, about that he's thinking all the time. And all those intelligent people, he is not at all speaking that I don't have any time. That who are actually intelligent people, they are not at all speaking that, not at all speaking foolish things that I don't have any time. Like this, they are not at all speaking at all. That Bhagwan Shri Krishna is actually speaking to Uddhav Ji Maharaj. Uddhav Ji Maharaj actually asking that, Prabhu, who is the actual intelligent person? That who is actually Daridra? That who is actually Daridra? That who is unsuccessful? All these kind of questions he is speaking. Who is actual topmost intelligent? Bhagwan has given all the answers to Uddhav Ji Maharaj. Bhagwan speaking that, you see Uddhav, that those who are actually thinking that they are actually very intelligent, that Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking that each and every person, according to their own estimation, they are thinking that they are very much intelligent. That according to their own estimation, each and everybody thinking that they are so much intelligent. That is actually truth. But the actual intelligent, who is that person? That Bhagwan actually speaking to Uddhav Ji Maharaj. Thank you. That Uddhav, Bhagwan Shri Krishna speaking to Uddhav, that you see, the topmost intelligent, that actual intelligent person is that who is thinking that this 2 days life he has got. That this unstable life just of 2 days, he is actually thinking that how to get that transcendental spiritual absolute truth. He want to attain that. He is just getting all his efforts involved in that. He is the topmost intelligent. That for absolute truth, topmost supreme absolute truth, in order to understand that supreme absolute truth, he is making all the efforts. He is actually intelligent. Otherwise, all are unintelligent. That this 2 days life, he is actually thinking, he is getting that. But after that, how to get that topmost nectar in his life? That kind of all efforts he is putting, that is the actual intelligent person. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking in the Kirtan and writing very nicely in Kirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking in Kirtan very nicely. Very nicely Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing and speaking in the Kirtan, that they are actually topmost intelligent persons, actually those who are thinking that they are thinking they are very topmost. So though for intelligent persons they won't speak like that, that who is Daridra, who is fallen actually. Bhagwan Shri Krishna speaking that the fallen person is one. That fallen is that who is all the time, he is actually unstable and he is very unsuccessful, thinking himself very unsuccessful. That who is Ajitendriya, who is Kripan, who is fallen, who is not at all making his mind by body, speech and mind, he won't be able to organize that onto lotus feet of Bhagwan at all. That he is actually fallen, Kripan. That who is Ajitendriya, who is not having control over his sense organs, whose sense organs are uncontrollable, and his body, speech and mind, everything, nothing, he is not at all giving it for Bhagwan. That is actually fallen. Who is actually topmost intelligent? That intelligent person is the one who knows about that Bhagavat Tattva. That is actually the topmost intelligent person. Actual intelligent is that person only. That he is the topmost intelligent person who, by knowing that, who knows about that Bhagavat Tattva, who can understand that supreme absolute truth. That is all the answers given by Bhagwan. And Bhagwan speaking to Uddhav, you see, that our even fraction of second, what we are having, that it should be used for the service of Bhagwan, Hari Bhajan. In that, each and every person, that according, in order to get his absolute mangal, he should try to do his absolute mangal. Because for that, Swartapal is very much important. That what is actually our in our Vaishnav society, it is there. If all the in the material society will be discussing this, they will all be thinking us mad. The Prabhupada speaking that according to their own, there should be the topmost absolute mangal for each and every individual entity there. Swarthpar means he should be selfish about his own absolute mangal. You see, the Prabhupada speaking this, that about his own self, who don't know about his own self, how we can speak him selfish? Who don't know that what is self, that kind, what is real self, he don't know. That he don't have the actual knowledge of self, that how you can speak that he is selfish. That Bhagwan actually speaking, you see, in this context, that each and every person in his life, that topmost absolute mangal, that is very much important for each and every person, that every person should be swarthapar, means that if some person will be listening, that he will be becoming very angry. Oh, what? We have to be swarthapar? Means that for his own Atma Mangal, he has to do everything. And whatever there in this material world, swarthapar means swarthi, that who is very much naughty. But in Paramarth, it won't be getting attached at all. Each and every person, the Prabhupada speaking, that according to his own mangal, he has to do his own mangal definitely. And swarthapar, swa-arthapar definitely should be there. Some selfishness should be there. But in this material world, all the persons which are there in this material world, almost all persons, almost 100%, 99.99% people in this material world, they are getting this apasarth. And all actually busy in this, apart from Krishna Seva, they are actually busy in Maya Seva. All that, each and every person, according to his own mangal, he is actually thinking of his absolute mangal, of his own. But mostly 99.99% of this absolute of this material sansar, apasarth means they are just thinking of their own Maya Seva. They are actually busy in that. All external affairs, which are useless and temporary. That the child, actually they are busy in sansar dharma, and in old people they are actually busy in business, and they are just maintaining their body, how to maintain that. And each and everyone, someone actually is busy in political activities, and they are actually just taking one kind of political background. They are actually busy in that, and someone actually busy in society seva, this seva, that seva. So all and other, they're just making one kind of drama, and they are just doing all kind of nonsense. They are actually looting the people on the basis of seva. All our childhood are just going wasting in getting playing games. Our childhood should be full of pure, and our job one should be pure, and our old age should be the topmost siddha stage we should attain. That our childhood, what is there, that childhood should be full of purity. And prabuddha means that it should be fully pure, and it should be very beautifully arranged about the transcendental knowledge we should get about that divine knowledge. Our whole childhood, that in small childhood, we just need to provocate all those kind of spiritual practices in our life, that all gyan vigyan, in order to get that absolute truth, we to know about that, that Brahma jigyasa should be there all the time about that absolute truth. But and it should be totally pure, and our old age should be the topmost siddha stage, each and every person. But it is not possible for everyone, not at all possible. Prahlad Maharaj actually speaking in this context. Prahlad Maharaj is speaking in this context. That in Komaur stage, that who is very, very small, that there, whenever he is getting consciousness, what he needs to do, that he is to do Hari Bhajan. In Komaur stage, when attaining that stage of Komaur, that Bhagavad Dharma he is to do acharan of that under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. It doesn't mean that in old age only he will follow that, but in old age nothing will happen at all. It is just one kind of, if we want to burn sand or earth, then definitely again, that first we just need to, the raw stage of the sand, if we are giving some shape and design to the sand, if the sand is getting burned, then the property is just getting destroyed of that particular sand or mud. So nothing can be made out of that. So in this way, our childhood should be very much full of pure, and our target should be pure and focused, and our old age should be topmost siddh. That should be the siddh stage we should attain. For each and every person, it should be applicable for every person. That's why Prahlad Maharaj is speaking that, oh people, oh my friends, that in childhood, that Bhagavad Bhajan is, you have to start. Whenever you are getting consciousness, you need to start Hari Bhajan under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. Why? Because this kind of transcendental bliss you will get, what you are actually listening. That whole world is actually running for that transcendental, for that peace. What is the actual definition of this peace and stability? what is the actual situation of this material sansar, that each and every person is actually just going for that happiness, but that actual swaroop of that happiness that is not at all getting exhibited inside the heart of anyone. If it is getting exhibited, then they won't be running for that at all. If it is getting exhibited, then like foolish people, they won't be running for that at all. That in this material world, each and every person, that according to his own upper swarth, he is actually running for that. Whole selfish moods he is going. That what the transcendental sampatti of this transcendental world, even 0.1 fraction of second, they don't want to give it for the to know about the transcendental world. But for to do Maya Seva, they have lot of time, infinity time they are having. Lot of time they are having to do Maya Seva. So that 100 out of 100%, 99.99%, 0.00001%, even that person won't come in that counting. So that's why it's almost nil that we can find that kind of person is there. That all childhood we are actually busy in playing, and in Kumar stage we are actually young stage we are busy in enjoyment, and in old age we just want to protect our body and just need to get all kind of material enjoyments. About this in Bhagavad Gita Mahapura it's already written. That is the actual truth. That our own, for our own selfish motive, what is the actual selfish motive? That about that actual selfish motive, he is all the time actually getting. He is feeling unhappy all the time. If you are making this vichar, then you can get the topmost vichar. All money, position, name, fame, all in all this, that they pure Guru Vaishnav don't have any interest in that at all. If you are not at all getting confidence, then you just stay with them for some times, then you can understand. You are actually unstable, so you can't understand. You just stay with them, then only you can understand. Then you can only understand. Actually, that name, fame, position, about anything, they don't have any interest about that at all. No interest at all they are having. About that, no interest at all about that. That's why in Gita, Bhagavan actually speaking. That one Sangyami, stable person, that sadhu, and one stable and topmost sadhu, in this materially temporary world, that just by seeing the different colors of this material world, very quietly he is actually laughing of this material world, that different colors of this material world he is just seeing, and that pure Guru Vaishnav, they are all the time laughing just by seeing them. That about that paramarthik vishaya, topmost transcendental vishaya, that we can get the topmost Atma Kalyan, that all the persons of the material world, especially they are not at all getting engaged in that. They have no interest at all in their engagement, and they are all the time sleeping in those kind of transcendental vishay. But all those pure Guru Vaishnav, all the time they are active in those kind of transcendental vishay. In these vishay, all the time they are actually so that they can't get even fraction of second they can lose in those, because this life is just like a fine sharp razor we are actually moving all the time. This is the actual point. That's why in the transcendental vishay, all this material world, they are actually just sleeping, they are unconscious, they are less interested to get the knowledge about that. That's why in the spiritual transcendental practices, that pure Guru Vaishnav all the time are alert. Even fraction of second they are getting disadvantaged, they are all the time careful about that, very cautious. that on that wish, name, fame, position, money, enjoyment, material enjoyment, that all the material people are actually busy in those, that all those pure Guru Vaishnav, they are just closing their eyes in all those wishes. That who will be actually listening all those foolish and rubbish talking? Mahaprabhu speaking this point, no, to Raghunath Das Goswami Pad. That is the topmost point which Bhagwan has spoken in Gita. Each and every person, that they are all the time. In Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking in Kirtan, very nicely he is writing Kirtan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In Bengali he is writing that. What it's written? In the childhood that I with all other child, my life, the time has gone in just playing with other children. And when I am just getting some consciousness, then at the time, just to study this and that, all these subjects I was started wandering in those, all this material education. And just studying that. Like this my life is going, and in the young, when after young life all material enjoyment and all marriage I have done, and after that in the old age that 5 kind of diseases have just covered from all the 4 directions, and now how to do bhajan, you tell me. So in the old age, if you are thinking that kind of just to protect your body and for the protection of body, all this material vishay, all the time they are actually busy. But what our actual selfish motive, what Srila Raghunath Das Goswami Pad actually speaking for our actual instruction, that they have given the instruction to our heart, that all the time he is actually getting involved in that. Who is actually intelligent, that all those material people, that for material selfish motives, for that collection of material selfish motives, they are all the time active in that and just to collect that. Because of that, they are not at all thinking about their transcendental selfish motive. That transcendental selfish motive, they are not at all thinking of that. They are all the time unhappy regarding that. It means they are unhappy in this transcendental selfish motive. Some persons are like that. That just for his own Atma Mangal, that it is not at all required. Whatever the position you are at present, that all those material people are there, that they are actually speaking, that be practical they are speaking. What practical they can understand, their father knows what is practical. But what they are speaking the be practical. Even their Shastras also speaking, they are all philosophy, they are not at all fact. They are speaking, so foolish number one, or you are foolish what you are speaking. They are speaking like that, yes. They are not, it's just, if they are speaking some Shastra, they are speaking, oh, it's just philosophy, what to hear. The be practical, just like foolish they are speaking. They don't have any idea at all about the transcendental world, that whatever written in the Shastra, this is just not philosophy. This is not philosophy. This is actual fact. Just by opening your eyes, you just need to see that. But you are not at all seeing at all, because your eyes are closed. So, some people are just like, they are speaking like this, that in this present situation, that kind of selfish motive, what actually is going on, that just for the Atma Mangal, there is no use of thinking of your own selfish interest, the transcendental selfish interest of yours. Don't need to understand that at all. They are speaking that how the actual situation is arising, how the situation is actually arising, according to that you need to go ahead. That in the future, whatever actually is coming in front of you, just need to think of that. That's it. This is their aim of life. But this is not at all good at all. This is totally opposite. Why? Because from the childhood, that when you are not at all getting that purity, definitely in the coming, when that kind of Shastri Gyan, if you are not at all getting from the childhood, that in the young life, definitely you will get involved in unstable conditions. And you will get into fallen condition. For those who are actually thinking of this material world just to get the advantage of the material people, and just to make sure, if just about their own material motive, he is actually thinking of the others' motives also, then it is good. But the actual dharma of the chetana, consciousness, is Bhagavad Seva, in which that the actual dharma of Chetan is Bhagavad Seva. That no kind of barrier is there at all for Bhagavad Seva. That is the actual Atma Dharma. That is spontaneous. Whatever kind of barrier is coming, they are not at all actually considering that. That is the actual Chetan Dharma, in which no kind of material enjoyment, even smell of enjoyment, is not at all there. And different kind of problems, that barriers, they are not at all thinking of that at all. Nothing will be there. Their condition is stable in that only. The material people, that they are all the time busy in Pap and Punya, that they don't know about Guru Tattva at all, that they are just speaking, how they can understand Guru, Ghoshta, Ghoshta. They are not at all thinking what is Guru Tattva. They don't have any idea about Guru Tattva, what they can understand about Guru. You see, they don't have any idea about them. That actual intelligent person is the one who is all the time busy in transcendental Vishay, that his own Atma, about his topmost Mangal, he's actually thinking of his Atma. All the time he's busy in that how he can find his relationship with Bhagwan, and he has to do Bhagwat Seva. And just by getting away from Bhagwan, there is no use at all. No use. Time is Paramarth, Prabhupada is speaking. That those persons in their life, that they are actually using the time in a correct way, who haven't used their correct time in a correct way, then definitely they have to face problems. And if by the kripa of Bhagwan, what kind of intelligent and vichar dhara we are getting from Bhagwan, the seva, what he has done before 20 years, up till just because of the lesser time, that is not at all done for now. What the seva done in Karuna period, but done by Bhagwan, all actually Bhagwat, Sanskrit and Gita Mool, different kind of Harikathas. Now, I don't have any time to speak now. This Bhagwan has already done. Otherwise, it is not at all possible, because nobody is actually coming here. For each and everyone, I am not at all getting association with anyone. It just by the kripa of Bhagwan it is done. So much Kirtan, so much Sanskrit, Bangla, everything is done. Bhagwan, at the right time, he is actually doing according to that time period, he is actually doing. And actually, it is all done by the kripa of Krishna. If now it is done, it's not at all possible, because no time is there. So whatever be the case, that Prabhupada speaking, the Prabhupada speaking, that to time is Paramarth, to correctly use time for Hari Bhajan, just by speaking rubbish, talking, no use of that at all. Now, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, that Virichit, Sri Manasiksha, that I am actually discussing that in front of you. So in that, that what your own mantra you are getting from your Gurudev, that what you have got from Mahamantra, inside that onto lotus feet of Yugal Kishore Radha Govind, all the time, that without any kind of dumb, you just should get spontaneous and tremendous attraction towards that Yugal Kishore lotus feet. It's in this very important point is there, that Goswami Jan, that whatever kind of different shastras they have just written or they have discovered in front of us, that all Sriman Mahaprabhu is according to the instructions of Sriman Mahaprabhu. it is the topmost that whatever the instructions of Sriman Mahaprabhu, that is the explanation of the instructions of Sriman Mahaprabhu. That what Sriman Mahaprabhu has given instruction, that is the actual explanation what they have just discovered in front of us. So, that's why Sriman Siksha, whatever Raghunath Das Goswami Pad actually just giving instruction definitely to his heart. But here, that actually in-depth vichar is that slowly, steadily, this by Sriman Siksha, that we are actually just putting us in Rupanukdhara, in a very secret form, we are actually moving towards that Rupanukdhara. That kind of, it means that whatever instructions Mahaprabhu has given, that about that scientific and detailed explanation is already given by Sriman Siksha by Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, because that with Guru Ghoshte, that word Ghoshte is written. So by this we can understand that Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, that what that Manasiksha has given, that in order to just instruct our heart, in order to just base up our heart, so that our heart can just go into the Rupanugdhara. That is the actual main secret goal of Raghunath Das Goswami Pad. What is the actual mool or root of the instructions of Mahaprabhu Siksha? Whatever the actual root of the instructions of Sriman Mahaprabhu, that to do Krishna Seva is the actual Nitya Dharma of all the Jeeva Atmas. It's secretly, if you can see Raghunath Das Goswami Man Siksha, that is the topmost root cause. What is that? That Prem is the topmost Nitya Dharma of all the Jeevas. That Prema, that kind of Prem Dharma, that all the Jeevas will get Krita-Kritarth. And they can't get out of that transcendental bliss at all, because that is the Nitya Dharma for each and every Jiva. That Shri Krishna, just to get the consciousness towards Krishna consciousness, to get that, we just need to throw away the Maya consciousness, and we just need to get attracted towards all the Anurag, towards the Krishna Seva. And gradually, just by the association of pure Guru Vaishnav, slowly, steadily, that we are just instructing our heart, and slowly, steadily, it will be going away, and that dharma, that Nitya Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma in secret form, that will just go inside, in a secret form, inside the heart of all the Jivas, it will just get activated. Just the Jivas who are very much lucky, they can understand that I am actually Nitya Krishna Das, then all kind of problems just can get rectified immediately and automatically. That in this same Vishay, according to that topmost absolute supreme Vishay, that the actual Mangal, that is the actual root cause of all the Mangal what you will get. Nothing else, that is the actual Mangal, Mangalmay Vishay. The shloka which I have started with, what is that? The topmost anurag, just to get the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnav. Upasana means that to worship the lotus feet. Thus, in front of Gurudev, we just need to stand in front of Gurudev and just need to serve Guru Vaishnav. That is the actual meaning of this shloka. Just to do the worship of Guru Charan, that's by serving pure Guru Vaishnav's lotus feet. That whatever kripa Gurudev has given, that topmost kripa you are actually getting. By that topmost agyan, you just need to cut that and throw it away. That I got topmost vidya what he has given us, in order to cut that avidya, that we just need to take that razor sharp weapon so that avidya can get cut off. That is the, just in order to get rectify the actual present situation of the jivas. Apramat means that don't show any kind of foolishness, because maya, in Maya, everything is getting destroyed by Maya only, and everyone is getting mad by Maya. Just topmost alert you should remain all the time, you should get alert. and whatever kind of bondage you are having. Bhagwan speaking that jivas are having no bondage at all. The bondage and mukti is just one kind of assumption. Bhagwan speaking this in the 11th canto. Bhagwan speaking to Uddhavji that you see, jivas don't have any bondage at all. Bondage is just assumption. That's it. Jivas is actually chinmay in nature. Transcendental. Jivas are all chinmay, transcendental. They don't have any relationship with this material world at all. But that kind of assumption what they are making, that I am this, I am getting unhappy, I am getting happy about this. I have already told you, no, previously about Vyasdev Goswami Pad actually at the bank of Saraswati River. He is actually just thinking about Bhagwan. Now, like this, that with full analas bhav, that topmost continuously onto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, if you are doing seva, performing seva.
Evam Guru Pasanaiko Bhakta Vidya Kutharyanu Sita Nadhir Sita Nadhiro Vibhrishya Jeeva Sayamayam Apramutto Sangbhrishya Atmanam Atho Tejyasthi. Guru Goshte Goshtalesu Sujane Bhusuragane Shamantre Sinamani Brajanava Juvadanda Sarane Sadadambyam Hitva Kururatima Purvam Matitaram Aye Shantar Bhatos Chatubira Vijate Dhitapada.
Guru Goshte Goshta Pichle Kaisa.
That from previous lot of time I have already discussed this point. What do you mean by Guru? That it means Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru and Sadguru. We just need to accept him. That previous weeks I have already discussed that about Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran, that 87 chapter, that in Veda Stuti it is written. What actually written here? That your heart is actually compared with a mad horse. That which in order to control is very, very difficult, next to impossible. Very, very difficult to control it. It's not a normal thing at all. That in order to just instruct this mind and heart is so much difficult, that so much difficult it is that you can't even can't ask about that. Why? Because this bonded jiva, bonded heart, in order to train and instruct him, he will not at all, because dumb is there, no? That ego is there. I have already learned this. He won't be actually accepting your instruction. That's why it is actually difficult to control your mind. But still, it is possible. How? If Jagadanand Pandit, that Prem Vivarth he has written, if we can just understand that, then apart from that, the topmost straight thing is nothing is there. What Jagadanand Pandit has told regarding this? Jagadanand Pandit has told. So nicely actually, he is actually speaking. That even one word, everything he has just explained in one word. How he, when he'll become saral? What do you mean by saral? What do you mean by saral? That Jagadanand Pandit is actually speaking. If he is becoming saral, then no complication is actually coming, no complexity is coming. Then by getting saral, then automatically that instructions of Gauranga Mahaprabhu can enter. That if otherwise you cannot understand the instructions of Mahaprabhu at all. In this, all kind of topmost secrecy is there. Saral means, that is actually called Saral. That inside and outside, that outside is something else and inside something else, not like that. Inside and outside, the same kind of behavior is there. No kapat bhav is there. Nishkapat. That for himself, he don't need any kind of respect and he is giving respect to others. What Mahaprabhu has told, everything will be done automatically. Everything will be done, no? You will be successful. But this is very much difficult. That for us, it is very difficult. The topmost easy is this. Apart from this, most easy option is no there. But for us, it's very difficult. You understand the point? Very nicely, see, Jagannath Pandit has written. Bhagavad-gita Mahapuran also, in the 10th canto, the 87th chapter, that shloka which I have already told you, that is very much surprising and amazing. That this mind and sense organs, in order to control them, is very much difficult. Very, very difficult. Next to impossible. How much pressure you will be putting on your mind and heart, that material mind and heart, whatever kind of pressure you will be putting on it, then more and more you will be, your opposite result you will be get. That on your heart and mind, more pressure for controlling you will be putting, the opposite result you will get, because it's just like a mad horse. You will get opposite result. That forcefully it won't be done at all by pressurizing your mind and heart. That about this, who will be actually doing more caring of this heart, he'll be getting more pressed by that. Everything will get fed up. That whatever kind of Vyasan and Durvasana, everything, you just need to throw it away. And if you take the ashraya of pure Guru Vaishnav, then automatically it will get controlled. Very easily you can get control over your mind. Very easily you can get control over your mind. If you can accept this point, what I told you. Guru Anugatha. That whatever kind of efforts he'll be putting, automatic opposite result will come for that. Forceful efforts, no use at all. It means that whatever you will be actually, some actually speaking that try to get control over mind, every procedure is that, this is the actual procedure. But the topmost procedure is what? To get Guru Charan, lotus feet of Gurudev. Apart from that, nothing is more topmost. That those who are doing pratyahar, pranayam, pratyahar, they are actually just putting their mind out of the material things. Whatever kind of efforts they are putting, but still this heart won't be getting control at all. It is just by taking shelter of pure Guru Vaishnav, that's it. By that only it can get control. Anyhow, it won't get control by all these kind of systems. You will just get mad by just following all these kind of rituals. So that's why it is actually written here.
व्यासन सतामृतो समवहाय गुरुस चरण बनी दिवाज पंत की कर्ण दरा जलोध
जैसे एक लाइक वन बोट बिग बोट इज देयर इनसाइड दैट दैट समवन एक्चुअली शोइंग द पाथवे
some boatman is showing the pathway. He's showing the pathway there. This is actually Guru Charan. That kind of ocean of this material. That's why it is told that by worshipping Guru, that automatically, that just by the seva of pure Guru Vaishnav, lotus feet, what can't be done, everything is done by that. Everything is done by Guru Vaishnav sevas, lotus feet seva. Everything can be done by that. That the actual proof is already there in Srimad Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran. It's already there in that. That this kind of material ocean, that kind of topmost bhela, there is no direction, which direction it will go, we don't have any idea about that. It can go anywhere. We can't see anything there. In this condition, that what kind of, what we need to do in this condition? That Guru Charan Ashray, that is the topmost, we need to secure the place there at the lotus feet of Shri Gurudev, Guru Charan. That if some businessman is actually in some ocean, he is actually going from the ocean, and in between the ocean he is just getting stuck. Some very nice businessman, he just got stuck in the ocean while traveling. And now Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, that Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru, about that some conception I have just discussed, that who actually have to accept Siksha Guru, that who onto the lotus feet of Diksha Guru, that actual Sadguru, he is having full respect, that onto the lotus feet of Diksha Guru, that who is actually increasing bhakti day by day. About Diksha Guru, if he is actually speaking all rubbish, then he is not at all Siksha Guru at all. If my Gurudev is actually Sadguru, is topmost, that Siksha Guru, then onto the Lord, the Siksha Guru, his role is that just to glorify him, that Siksha Guru. Uddhavji Maharaj is speaking to Sukhdev Goswami. Uddhavji Maharaj, Sukhdev Goswami Maharaj, Bhagwan actually speaking to Uddhavji Maharaj. And Parikshit Maharaj actually, Sukhdev Goswami Pad actually speaking to Parikshit Maharaj. Sukhdev Goswami Pad actually speaking to Parikshit Maharaj. That what actually told? By Rajogun, that Tamo, and by Sattogun, you just need to remove Tamo and Rajogun. After that, under Guru Anugatya, that you just need to take that medicine. That what is that medicine? That Harinam Mahamantra Kirtan part, Harikatha Kirtan, all this seva, go on doing that under the guidance of pure Guru Sadhu, under the pure Sadguru Vaishnav, under their guidance. Upasam means that remedy, that medicine you just go on taking under the pure Guru Vaishnav Anugatya, just go on doing that. What will be done? That onto lotus feet of Guru Dev, that Guru Bhakti, everything will get sorted. And your heart, your mind, this is actually very unstable, your heart. So, Shri Guru means that Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru, both are, and Padma Padaksha Guru is also there. About that, this vichar, it is, I have not at all told that Raghunath Das Goswami has told this conception of Padma Padaksha Guru, about Guru. That only this Guru, Gurau Ghoshta, this word is actually spoken. And the Guru, the word Guru, after that Gurau Ghoshta, Ghoshta from where it has come? Raghunath Das Goswami Path. Guru Goshte, just by speaking this, there is one indication given that about Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan, that indication is given by Raghunath Das Goswami Path. Normal, ordinary Guru is not at all speaking at all. Shri Guru, Sikha, Sikha Guru and Diksha Guru, that what kind of rati and attraction should be there, tremendous attraction should be there for Gurudev. About this, it has been told by Raghunath Das Goswami Path here. After that, Brajadham. Goshta means Brajadham. What else? Goshta means Brajadham and nothing else. In these days, we were actually about Guru Tattva and Guru, the glorification of Guru Tattva and Guru. How onto the lotus feet of Gurudev we just need to do Atma Nivedan and Ratimati we have to do. About this we were actually discussing from previous days, lot of weeks we are discussing this. And now, and Guru Goshte, Goshta, just by speaking, the Goshta means that where actually cows are staying. Goshte, that is the place where cows are staying. Ghost means where cows are actually grazing grass, about which in Brahma Samhita it's already told there. This already being told. So if you can see that the vichar is actually correct. Goshta means that Brajabhumi. Brajadham. Brajadham. Braja. From where this word Braja has come, if someone actually is asking. From this word Braja, where from it is coming? That the actual meaning of Braja word means that where the actual birth of Brahm is done, that is called Braja. Bhaja means Ja means Janma, taking birth. Where that Parabrahm Paratpara Akhileshwara, that Parabrahm, where he is getting Avirbhav. Bhagwan actually don't have any Avirbhav Tirubha, but still he is having that. That is actually one kind of Leela. So Brajadham, just by speaking that, it means that Bhaja, that where Brahm is actually taking birth, Brajanath, it is actually getting matured, no, day by day, that each and every fraction of second, Brajan we are speaking. That is called Vibhu Vastu. Brajan. Brajan means that it is just go on increasing day by day. That is called Brajan. That Brajati. This means Radha Kunjavat. That Brajamandal. Hall which is coming there. Nandagaon, Barsana, everyone, everything. That Brajadham actually is actually being spoken there. That Mahaprabhu's and Srinath Vishwanath Chakravarti Path, the actual summary of Mahaprabhu's instructions, it's already there. It's actually openly being told here. Here, actually, it's being spoken. What it is written? Here, actually, it is written, you see. That our Aradhya Bhagwan Shri Krishna, that Nandanandan Krishna, but that his Vrindavan Dham, with that Dham, not individually, along with Vrindavan Dham, together with the Vrindavan Dham Krishna. Here actually it is spoken. How we have to do Seva? That under the guidance of Brajvadugan, that how they are serving Krishna and Dham, that is the actual Adarsh, etiquette we need to follow under their guidance. Like this we have to follow.
Aradha Bhagavan Bhujasastvara
that how Vrajvadugans have done their seva, and in the Shastras, according to the vichar of the Shastras, that there is some kind of that Narottam Das Thakur speaking that Bhagavatam is the topmost. This actually told by Narottam Das Thakur, the same thing, that Srimad Bhagavatam, now this Brajadham, this actually the meaning of this Brajanath means that all the time it is actually going on increasing spontaneously, that Vrajanshil, that Brajadham, this is actually Vibhu Vastu, that it is not different from Bhagwan. This we need to understand, and Bhagwan, whatever kind of names and whatever dham is there, lot of dhams are there of Bhagwan, Jagannath dham, then Rameshwaram dham, all dhams are there of Bhagwan. Rameshwaram, Badrika Ashram, Dwarika dham, Ayodhya dham, all every dham is there. Out of that, the topmost of all the dham is Vrindavan. Vrindavan is the topmost. That is, it is his own house of Bhagwan, that Brajadham. In this, it's already written Gokul, Nandishwar, Govardhan, Shyam Kund, Radha Kund, all are actually coming inside that, where that different kind of leelas of Bhagwan, where Bhagwan has manifested different leelas, it is that is actually called Dham. All are actually Dham. So Raghunath Das Goswami Pad in Manasiksha, that previous which I have already told, Guru Ghoshte means he wants to speak that in Vrindavan, that ghost, that Brajadham, that Leela Sthali of Bhagwan, that Srila Rup Goswami Pad also writing the same thing. Srila Rup Goswami Pad also in his stotra, he is writing the same thing. Different kind of vichar he has just manifested in front of us. Srila Rup Goswami Pad writing very nicely. This very nicely is actually speaking. Srila Rup Goswami Pad is very nicely and beautifully speaking in the Kirtan. Srila Rup Goswami Pad also is actually speaking very nicely that there are some comparative statement is given that Vaikunth, that Madhupuri, from Vaikunth Madhupuri is more ahead, where Bhagwan has done Leela and different play and childhood pastimes he have manifested, and out of that Madhupuri Govardhan is topmost, and out of that Govardhan also that Radha Kund is topmost, where actually the ocean of Prema is actually getting, flood of Prema is coming in Radha Kund, that is the topmost, and more topmost than Govardhan. Who is there in the Radha Kund that in all this Vishay is not getting any kind of tremendous attraction at Rati? Is there any person like this in this context, that who is actually not at all feeling that tremendous attraction, who is not at all, he is foolish, foolish person is there who will not show agra. So that's why Brajadham Guru Ghoshte means where all the cows are actually just Gokul, Nandishwar, Govardhan, Yavat, Shyamkund, Radhakund, everywhere where all Krishna Leela has been manifested. With that first Guru Ghoste, the first we have to just take the lotus feet of Gurudev, and after that Raganuga Guru, Rupanuga Gurudev, we just need to take his shelter, who is all the time actually getting Vicharan in Ghosht. And after that Brajavasi, that about Brajavasi, that conception that normal person are thinking, that this, those who are living in Braj, that he is actually Brajavasi. This conception they are actually speaking, that those who are living in Braj externally, they are only Brajavasi. That Deep Prabhupada speaking very nicely in this context, that externally, that lot of people are living in Brajadham, externally. Externally, lot of people are actually living in Brajadham. In Brajadham, Hayavasi are not at all Brajavasis. And a Prakrit definition of Brajadham, that Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, about Brajadham, he is actually used to love each and everyone in Brajadham, Raghunath Das Goswami Pad. If I will speak in context to this, that you will become very much surprised about this. All that time that he used to speak 2000 Vaishnava and he used to do Dandavat Pranam. If you will do 2 to 4, you will just die. If you will do 2 to 4, you will die. He used to do 2000 Vaishnava and used to do 2000 Vaishnava Pranam, Dandavat Pranam, by 2000 times. And did so much lakhs of Harinam and used to take bath in Radhakund all day and night. Oh my God. How about that? Goswami's, that in Ashtakam also it is written, in the Goswami Ashtakam, it's written there, that it's already written there in the Goswami Ashtakam. Very nicely it is actually being spoken. No time we have, all the time. No time they are having, all the time, that Nandanandan Bhagwan, in order to satisfy Nandanandan Bhagwan, and about your own selfish motive, no smell of selfish motive is there. Who is actually Brajavasi? That who is all the time feeling the sensual gratification of Nandanandan Bhagwan Shri Krishna. Whole day and night he is able to serve Bhagwan Shri Krishna's senses. In his life, no other matter is there, no other work is there. How to satisfy Bhagwan day and night? He is actually thinking of that, making efforts. That is actually called Brajavasi. Each and every person is not Brajavasi. He is actually, if I am going, I have money, I can stay in Braj. Okay, you can stay in Braj externally, but he is not Brajavasi at all. It is not like that, no. That Brajavas, Goswamis, under the Anugatya of Goswamis, we have to do Brajavas. Deep Prabhupada used to speak, that to get the anugatya of Goswamis, that is actually we can get the Brajavas, actual result of Brajavas. Deep Prabhupada used to speak this. That under the anugatya of Goswamis only it is done. It's not like that you can do that. To just go in Braj, it's not like that. The Prabhupada used to speak that all our Gurudev, Guruvarga are actually a Prakrit Brajavasi. Why? Because in their life, each and one and one single, all the time, just for the satisfaction of Bhagwan and all the efforts to satisfy Bhagwan is actually we can see. That's why they are Brajavasi. Otherwise, all other are just by staying in Brajavasi. And it's not Brajavasi, but still Raghunath Das Goswami used to give respect to each and every Brajavasi there. That Brajavasi for Krishna Seva, that all, every time, fraction of second, he is using for Krishna Seva. He is sacrificing each and everything for the service of Krishna Seva. That is actually Brajavasi. So, by body, speech, and mind, that to stay in Brajadham, and just by physically, if he's, someone is not at all living in Brajadham, so then by mentally he can stay in Brajadham. What actually written here? By speaking Sujan, what do you mean by that? That Sajjan is actually called Sujan. If this vichar actually we are making, that Sajjan, that Sajjan, that like Bhaktivinoda Thakur is actually speaking about Sajjan Toshani. Sajjan means that who is Sat plus Jan, that is actually Sajjan. Who is actually Sat, that who is all the time actually having that satisfaction in Nitya Vastu, that is that in pure Guru Vaishnav only, that pure Guru Vaishnav only, the that Vishuddha Guru Vaishnav, that Sadguru is actually the name is titled as Sajjan. So Sajjan Toshani is the name what Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written. So that is Sajjan and Sujan Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually writing. That of whatever sampradaya is, because under four sampradayas, if someone is Param Vaishnav, okay, he is not from our own sampradaya. That he is not from our own sampradaya, okay, no problem. But that is actually Sat. Maybe Srila Rupa Goswami Pad has already written that full point in order to clear that in front of us. This point he has just manifested in front of us, Srila Rupa Goswami Pad. That in our own sampradaya, that our own sampradaya, that topmost sadhu of your own sampradaya, you just need to do the association of that sadhu. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad actually is not at all speaking this, that out of four sampradaya, that some Sajjan Sadhu, if you are getting, that you just need to throw him away. No, not like that he is speaking. Okay, that out of four Sampradaya, any Sampradaya, you are getting a good Sat Sadhu, that you just don't need to disrespect him or throw him. But the actual question is of bhajan. That your own bhajan, that your own requirement, if it is just your actual wish is to just serve the lotus feet of Prabhupada, is all the same what is the actual wish of Sadguru and you is same, then there is no problem at all of entanglement with your Gurudev and you. But if there is some kind of change between the wish of your Gurudev, Sadguru and you, then there can be a big problem in your bhajan regarding your own self. That Prabhupada speaking one time, that why actually it's all going this, because the interest of one person is not at all getting all together with the interest of other. The someone is doing having this kind of wish, the other person is having other kind of wish. So that's why there is some kind of entanglement. What kind of ashraya they have to take? Like Srila Sachidananda Bhakti Thakur, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Ashray, Srila Bhakti Vinod Puri Goswami Paramudiva, Sridhar Goswami Parampuja, Keshav Goswami Ashray, that is all one and the same ashray you are taking. It means that inside inner meaning, that secret Siddhanta, that kind of secret Rupanuga Siddhanta, that Bhava, what he wants, that is actually all together getting engaged, all at the same simultaneously with your Gurudev. So then only that ashray can be done. Then only it can be done. Very nicely matching sajati rase snigde sajatiyo. That ashray sampan. That is actually snigda. Snigda means that in English that is tranquil. This is not at all good to speak. In English we speak that we speak tranquil. If we translate philosophy we are speaking, that is not at all good, because philosophy, this word in English, it is actually English word, that in according to their previous sanskar and sanskriti, that kind of word we can see that philosophy, that accurate inner meaning it cannot get fitted in that our darshanik vichar, what we speak in Bengali, that actual darshanik vichar is Vedanta Darshan and Upanishad is all the same, and Bhagavad Darshan, and outside this there is no Darshan at all. That Darshan what I told is all useless apart from that. and in foreign that whatever kind of sanskar, sanskriti, it according to that, that what kind of word we are actually getting, they have different sanskar, and whatever word we are actually getting, they it is having a different background altogether, because Bhagwan is actually that purest word. This Bhagwan has just put in front of us that purest word, that so much accuracy is there, even slightest here and there, the meaning will just get changed. But other kind of words, there is no that kind of difference at all, whatever you can see. That all other kind of words, there is no that much accuracy is there. So that is very much important. So inside them, that philosophy word is definitely there. And if you can ask me that from where this word has come, this philosophy word, I don't know. But in our Sanskrit, each and every word, how it is actually getting derived, what is the actual root cause of that word, every actually proof is there regarding that. So their philosophy, their means, that when you are just speaking it in very mentally concocted details, you are actually giving, it is actually called philosophy. That's why material people are speaking that come to the point, be practical, foolish. Just by speaking, you can understand that he is material person. If he is actually speaking this word, that be practical, Maharaj. Just be practical. Are, this is all philosophy. Because these people, they are actually all contaminated with materialism. Their vichar is actually contaminated with materialism. It's totally wrong. Why? Because they are actually, just by speaking this word philosophy, definitely they are speaking some mentally concocted idea. But our darshanik, Bhagavad Darshan, is not like that. Our Bhagavad Darshan means that which is as it is darshan, that which darshan, that is actually absolute darshan, which is absolute darshan. What is my present darshan? This is just by the backing of Maya we are doing darshan. You understand the point? That what now that our darshan is there, this kind of darshan is actually backed by the effect of Maya Devi. It is on to the by the effect of Maya Devi, it is getting backing. That's why this darshan is not at all actual darshan at all. That actual darshan is done when Bhagavad darshan is done as it is. So in English, that's just by speaking philosophy, or when sometimes we are doing some translation, we are actually sitting, then this darshanik vichar, that philosophy, just by rating that, it's not at all good to speak. But still people are writing that philosophy. What to do? They are actually just writing like that. What we can do in that? The actual darshan, that our according to the darshanik Indian darshan, it's not like that. But foreign word, foreign country, they are using this word philosophy. So in this four sampradaya, if some pure sadhu is there, if there is no infighting is there in that, but which sampradaya he is, from particular sampradaya he is belonging, that pure sadhu, that by his swaroop, if he is not at all actually living in Braj by his own swaroop, eternal swaroop, that maybe he is from some other Bhagavad Sampradaya, that topmost pure devotee. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking in his context by his actual swaroop, who is not at all actually getting his eternal swaroop in Braj Dham, that he is actually Sajjan and he is very nice devotee and is all the time thinking of the other form of Bhagwan. Like this kind of sampradayik pure devotee or pure sadhu, these are actually Madhyam Bhagavat. They are not Uttam. Uttam Bhagavat is first, that those who are Brajvasis, that who all the time eternally with their swaroop actually present in Braj, they are actually actual Brajvasi. And Bhakti Vinod Thakur is not at all there in Braj, but all the time eternally he is doing seva in Braj Dham. All the time, Deep Prabhupada, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, they are actually Brajvasis, real Brajvasis. So this actually is called Sujan, Sajjan. He is actually Sajjan. And after that, what actually being told, Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, that Bhu Surugane, what does it mean? Bhu Sargane means, that Bhu means earth, is earth, Bhu. And in that sur, that what is actually Shrestha, what is that special? Shrestha, Bhu Surugane. Bhu means that earth, that mother earth, that sur. What is that? That is Brahmin. That Varnashram Dharma, Bhagwan actually speaking in context to Varnashram Dharma. Whatever kind of varna are there, that all are actually Brahman, Guru. So here, Brahman means that those who just by who are actually decorated with 12 qualities. It's not like that. Here, in the 6th canto, actually in the 7th canto it is written, if the opposite vichar is coming, then everything will get ruined. In the 7th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is written there in context to this, there Prahlad Maharaj actually speaking in context to this. Vipra, that who is having these 12 qualities, that six qualities, 6 multiplied by 2, that Dishado means 6 multiplied by 2, that total 12 qualities are there. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, that those who are having decorated with 12 qualities, all 12 qualities actually decorated with that. But if he has don't have any Vishnu Bhakti at all, then he is actually foolish, he is nothing at all. He is not at all Brahmin. Even onto the lotus feet of Bhagwan, that who is actually away from Bhagwan, lotus feet, then with 12 qualities, whether he is having, but still he is not at all believing in the service of Bhagwan, then he is not at all Brahman at all. Now you make this vichar, that actual Brahman, who is that actual Vastavik Brahman? Those who are having that topmost Astha in Bhagavad Charan, Vishuddha confidence, that otherwise his name is Shudra. That Brahman also is can also be eligible to become Shudra, and Shudra can also become eligible more than Brahman. How? Like Haridas Thakurji, externally he is actually just taking birth in a Yavan family, Muslim family, but at the Advait Goswami Pad, who is Sadashiv himself, he is actually speaking. What he is speaking? He is speaking that you are the topmost of all the Mahatma. If a Mahatma like you, if he is taking prasadam, that even millions and millions of Brahmans, it is not at all equivalent to them. That if you will take prasadam, then millions and millions of Brahmans, their prasadam will be done. That what kind of seva that Brahmans are having, it is not at all equivalent to them at all. So you are such a topmost of all. You are more than them. So very nicely he is actually speaking this. More than that, Advait Goswami himself speaking, who is actually himself Sadashiv, who is actual avatar of Mahavishnu, he is himself speaking. So definitely we have to believe that. Haridas Thakur speaking that why you are actually coming in this kind of contention, that you should give this prasadam to these Brahmans. I am actually from a low family. I am a low caste. Advait Goswami is actually, Haridas Thakur speaking to Advait Goswami like this. And Advait Goswami, what he is speaking? That you don't worry at all. You just be without worry. You just stay. I will do that what actually is written in the Shastras. That you just by taking prasadam, it is not even equivalent to millions of Brahmins. It is more than that. Advait Goswami himself speaking. So nicely actually spoken by Advait Goswami. So just by speaking Bhusurgan means that Brahmin. But every person will speak that I have that janeu, so I am also Brahmin by birth. You are not at all Brahman. You can be Brahman as well. Brahman means 12 qualities you can attain, but you can't be Brahman. Brahman is that who is all the time getting vicharan in Brahm inside his heart. Apart from Bhagwan, nothing is there at all. In my life already, I have seen that. Practically, one Brahman Vaishnav. He actually, someone requesting him, lot of persons, that I myself has shown practically just to serve the Mother Earth. When I was actually getting grown up in my family, one friend of mine is called Mukund. He is actually the Baba of that Mukund. And he is doing all the study there. And his father whole day, even actually is going in the pathway, he is half eyes are closed and speaking Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So nice Brahman. I have already seen that practically. And now I can't see it now at present. What I have already seen before, I have already seen that. That's it. That at the land, puja of some land, someone actually is checking that it's actually Chit Shakti Swarup only of Bhagwan, that Bhudevi, just to serve, just to do the puja. I have already seen that puja. Oh my God. So nice puja. Topmost Brahmin, topmost Brahman Vaishnav. That Brahman means that just by taking janeu, he is not Brahman at all. Just those drinking wine and alcohol, those who are taking ganja charas, these are all having that janeu. You are seeing that I am Brahman, you are having that janeu with me. You are just by janeu only that you will become Brahman. So that's why according to Varnashram Dharma, lot of vichar is there, I have already told you before. And there, lot of, from Bhagavad, from Mahabharat, lot of things I have already told, that I have already trying to discuss from there. And I just have proved from there differently, that under the guidance of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that from whosoever family you are belonging, that according to that pariche, that identification, that Jivatma is getting identified. That Jivatma's identification is not according to the family background at all. How you can get the identification of Jivatma? It's just by his behavior, what he's having. What is his actual behavior? Natural, nitya behavior. By that, Jivatma is getting identified. According to his behavior, that his varna is getting decided. Now that's... Nowadays, nobody will believe. Previously, it was there. Rishabh Dev, that he is the Shakta Vishavtar of Bhagwan. Okay, so whatever it will be, but he is Kshatriya. He is Kshatriya. How his son can become a Brahmin, you tell me? That he is one getting Kashi Karmakandi Brahman. Nav Yogendra also has come. And after that, Naraji Maharaj has came. How it is possible that he can become Brahman, as a boy of Kshatriya? How he can become a Brahman? Son of Kshatriya. And Jawal Satyakam, that Gautami Rishi, why he is speaking to Jawal Satyakam this point? When Jawal Satyakam is speaking to Gurudev, that Gurudev, you just tell me that Brahma Vidya, about that you just give me the topmost knowledge. Then Gautami Rishi is speaking that you just tell me the actual parichay of your father, that who is your actual father, because to give diksha to a normal person, it's not at all qualified to take, whether Shudra, Mataji or all fallen persons, they don't have any eligibility to take the mantra diksha, that Dvijvadhu, they are not at all eligible to just read Vedas, just to get the mangal that Mahabharata is actually getting discovered by Vedavyasji Maharaj, so that they can read that. But now the actual question is coming that, okay, this Brahmin, that boy, actually just Jawal Satyakam, he's actually asking that Jawal Satyakam just went to his house and speaking to his mother that what is the actual identification of my father. Then mother speaking that, you see, I can't speak that from where you have just gone, that I have done the association of lot of persons and after that you just came. And by this point, same point, he is actually putting in front of Gautami Rishi. In the whole Sabha, he is speaking so nice, straightforward. He is speaking that Gurudev, that mother actually have asked, mother speaking that I can't speak that by different association with different persons. And just by doing that, I am actually getting birth. And all the small boys were actually laughing at him. And then Gautami Rishi speaking, hey, stop laughing. That you are actually Brahmin, he is speaking. Why? Because apart from Brahmin, this don't have this kind of courage that he can speak that absolute truth in front of everyone. Nobody can speak like that. That definitely you are Brahmin. Now, come to me, I will tell you how to speak Vedas. In that, Gautami Rishi actually speaking. What he is speaking? That in Brahman, that Arjava, that topmost absolute vachan, that kind of sahas is there. That Shudra, he is actually speaking all rubbish. He just won't speak the actual thing. But Brahman is not like that. Okay, whatever will be done. Okay. So Brahman, just by speaking, you are speaking Sujan, then he is the actual diamond of this whole material earth. This Brahmin, Bhagwan, also in Brahma Samhita also is speaking very nicely. That Vedas are my actual vachan. What are the sadhus? That sadhus are my heart. They are my life and soul. You understand the point? Very nicely Bhagwan has just spoken this point. That Vedas are my vachan. That what I am speaking. Because vipra from the mouth of Brahmins, that Vedas are actually getting commenced. That Shastra Vichar is coming from the mouth of the Brahmin, a pure Brahmin. So whatever be the case. And other what it is there, rest of the things. That sadhu, he is the actual life and soul. He is my life and soul. So we can just very nicely, actually these details we can get. That sujan, in general, if that absolute conception we want to take, that the of the just by taking the present situation in front of us, then lot of vichars can come. That present situation, just by putting in front of us, the lot of questions can come in that. But that if by making that absolute vichar, the actual Brahman is doing that, then what it is that? That by their natural behavior, they're actually Brahman. Brahman is not this body, that not the color of this body, and Brahman is not at all your bonded mind and heart. It's nothing like that. Brahman, who is he? That who is that? Who is the natural behavior, that in his behavior, that kind of lotus feet of Bhagwan is there all the time. That is actually Brahman, and Brahmachari is also the same. Now, what is actually Brahmachari nowadays, or like Karmacharis? We don't know. Maharaji is actually Brahmachari or Karmachari? We don't know. Now the actual situation is like that. What to do? Brahmachari means that who is all the time getting vicharan in Brahm, all the time inside his heart, that the chintan, the consciousness towards Bhagwan is there all the time. That is actually Brahmachari. That Brahman also is the same. That who is having that attraction, tremendous attraction for Brahm, if it is not at all there, then he is not at all Brahman at all. That is the actual point. So, Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, this this Sujane, just by speaking this, lot of Bhaktivinoda Thakur Vichar and general Vichar and the actual in-depth Vichar what Bhaktivinoda Thakur has spoken, that Sujan means that those who are actually those who are in the fourth sampradaya from any sampradaya, that actual sujan and sajan, that who is actually doing the bhajan of Bhagwan, that according to the rasa vichar, that kind of difference can be there. And by the swaroop, eternal swaroop is actually residing in Brajadham, that kind of sampradayik bhagavad bhakta, that we can speak he is sujan. That just by speaking on the basis of that sajjan toshini Bhaktivinoda Thakur has just manifested what actually we are speaking in English as the harmonist, we are speaking that in English. He has manifested that in English. So these are all Uttam Bhagavat. And sujan, about that actually is being spoken, that about sujan I have already told you in details what actually is sujan. And bhusurgan, now bhusurgan I have just told you about bhusurgan. Now that varnashram, that who are having those topmost nishtha in varnashram, that those who are, about those foolish people I am not at all speaking. Those who don't have any kind of nishtha towards varnashram dharma and no nishtha for Bhagwan, nothing is there, and he is speaking that, oh, I am Brahman. He is not at all Brahman. This is not at all Brahman at all. Bhusurgan means that this Bhumi, this Mother Earth, that is the topmost of, that is actually Brahman in this Mother Earth. So that's why in the Shastra it is written, whatever Varna, that Brahman is the actual Guru of whatever, but he should be an actual Brahman. And our Guru Vaishnava, what is there externally, they are not at all Brahman, but they are actually the topmost Brahman. That they are actually transcendental Brahman. They are more topmost Brahman. They are not material Brahman. About this, Mahaprabhu actually spoken, just by the, in the form of Guru, you have to accept them. Mahaprabhu already speaking this point. That is actually Guru. So bhusurgan means that varnashram dharma, who are having topmost nishtha in varnashram dharma, those who are not at all breaking the varnashram dharma, and they are showing that I am just breaking the varnashram dharma, they are not at all Brahmin. Bhusurgan means that those who are the topmost of all the varnashram dharma, and they are actually guiding the varna and ashram, they are actually giving the actual instructions regarding how to follow varnashram dharma. So Prahlad Maharaj also actually speaking in context to this. The same thing is speaking, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually speaking is all the same. Prahlad Maharaj actually speaking. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur is also speaking the same thing. Externally, if we find it's all the same, similarity is there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that this varnashram dharma, those who are having their topmost astha and faith, and those who are Vaishnav dharma, those are instructing Vaishnav dharma, they are actually Brahman. That is actual Brahman. Those Madhyam Bhagavat, what? About this, I will be discussing it tomorrow. Now, I don't have, because of the lapse of time, I don't have time. So, on this special vishe, by the Kripa of Bhagwan, I will be showing you. And about this, about Madhyam Bhakta, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur actually has just told, Bhusurgan means that whatever all Brahmins we can see in this material world, especially in this Indian, in India, definitely Brahmins, in a foreign country, Brahmins are not at all there. Not at all, no chances there. Whatever he can speak that he is Brahman, he can't be there. It is not at all possible. And in India also, that what Varnashram Dharma, they are actually accepting. Who is accepting that in India? Because Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking, lot of things. About this, I will be discussing it tomorrow. So rare it is, that genuine Brahmar, how rare it is to get a genuine Brahmin. Lot of Shastric injunctions are there, what Bhagwan has told. Lot of Shastric injunctions has been told by Bhagwan. etc. All these shlokas are there, what Bhagwan told. Very less are there who are actually at least trying. Out of that, millions and millions out of that, one is there.
Very rare.
So now, whatever be the case, that Bhusurgan, it is not a normal thing. Bhusurgan is not a normal thing at all. That Varnashram Nishta, that Vaishnava Dharma Sikshak, that onto the lotus feet of Vishnu, those are having bhakti and full Nishta, and the same thing they are teaching to others, that is actually Brahman, they are actually Bhusurgan. That they, we can speak them Kanishta Bhagwat. About this, I'll be just discussing it tomorrow freely. About now, I'll be just taking rest up till tomorrow. Just forgive me.
Evam Guru Pasanaika Bhaktya Vidya Kutharena Sitena Dhiro Vibrishya Jiva Swayamayam Apramatto Sangrishya Atmanam Atho Tejo Asa Vijito Rishi Kovayu Viradam Tamuna Sturagam Jaya Jatam Tiyam Tumati Lolo Mupayo Kil Vyasana Satamrito Samabahaya Guru Charanam Dhanija Ivaja Santa Kita Karana Dharaja Ladho Vancha Kalpatrushti Kibasindu Bhavcha Patitanan Pabunibho Vaishnabhyo Namo.